Programa con buen pie, la mejor manera de continuar la semana. Yo estoy feliz, I feel blessed, y estoy más que, me siento muy halagada de tener hoy a un joven luchador, un joven hispano que ha tenido un sueño que le ha tocado, que aún está trabajando para seguir alcanzando sus metas, un joven que no se ha dado por vencido, que lucha cada día por ese sueño, preparándose durante toda una trayectoria. Y él es Miguel Baeza. Con fuerte aplauso, lo recibimos. Bueno, Miguel no habla mucho español, así que vamos a traducir muchas de las preguntas y yo voy a tener que traducir muchas de sus respuestas. Para ustedes, van a tener un poquito de paciencia, pero si usted tiene un joven hijo o una hija en casa que quiera. Qué bueno, ya, por lo menos sabe decir perdón. Pues dígale que venga ahora a ver esta sesión porque Miguel nos va a contar un poquito de cómo él ha alcanzado su sueño. Vamos a ver, vamos a darle la bienvenida a todas esas personas que te están mirando esta noche a través de este programa.
Say hello, everybody. My name is Miguel Baeza, and I'm really, blessed to be here. This is just an opportunity for me to kind of tell you my story. And again, thank you for being here and listening to me.
Great. Dice Miguel que buenas noches, que para él es una bendición poder estar en este programa, que es una oportunidad de llegar a todos ustedes. Así que vamos a empezar esta entrevista con este joven exitoso de Puerto Rico. Pero nosotros somos dominicanos, pero ya nosotros no
Hey,
los
it's all good.
robamos.
It's all good. Está bien. It's good.
Ah, Miguel, cuéntanos un poquito de tu vida. Voy a decir la pregunta en español y luego en inglés. Tell us a little bit about yourself.
Well, I grew up down here in South Florida, and I grew up in Davie, and I just kind of been back and forth between, being here down in Davie and seeing my family in Puerto Rico, and then coming to us, and then we've had some family in New York. But growing up, we were always into fighting, and boxing was a big part of my childhood. I would remember, when Tito Trinidad was fighting.
Tito
My,
Trinidad,
yeah, yeah.
puertorriqueño.
He would fight, and my uncle would throw a barbecue, a party. We'd all go out and see the fight. It'd be a big event. And after that, I was like, I don't know. I felt like it was meant to be.
Oh,
My uncle was
wow.
also an amateur boxer in Puerto Rico, so whenever I got to see him, he made me box.
Oh,
It
wow.
wasn't like always my choice. It was, hey, let's get the gloves, let's go. So.
Bueno, voy a hablar un poquito. Miguel nos está contando. Le pregunté que me contara un poquito de su vida. Dice que creció aquí, en Miami, en New York.
No, my family's from New
La
York, Puerto
familia de Nueva
Rico.
York y de Puerto Rico, pero él creció aquí en David,
Davie,
right? ¿Verdad
Davie.
que sí? Y dice que desde pequeñito le gustaba pelear. Le gustaba el boxeo. Dice que su papá y su tío le gustaba mirar a Tito Trinidad, el puertorriqueño, y hacían barbecue y fiesta para celebrar esas peleas. Y a él como que le inspiraba eso. Y aunque no es boxeador, Miguel es su ejercicio es el MMA.
MMA,
Muy
Mixed
bien.
Martial Arts.
Mixed Martial Arts, que es un tipo de karate mixto, de artes marciales. I got the word.
You got it.
Thank you. De arte marcial, I was thinking. Artes marciales mixtas es lo que Miguel, pues vamos a decir, ejerce. Esa es su carrera, no es de boxeo, pero es una pelea de arte marcial mixta.
Yeah, so boxing is a part of MMA.
Ok.
And the promotion is the UFC, which is one of the biggest mixed martial arts organization in the world right now. So I'm blessed to be a part of them, and they give me the opportunity to fight and be able to put my skills out there for everybody to see.
Wow, dice que el boxeo es parte de este tipo
MMA.
de MMA mixto, sí, de artes marciales. Estamos los dos así, Spanglish.
Yeah,
Yeah, that's fine. De
Spanglish.
artes marciales y que ahí pueden hacer otros ejercicios. Miguel, ¿cuánto tiempo llevas peleando y cuándo empezaste? How long have you been fighting, when
Comencé
did you start?
entrenando cuando tenía 15 años. I was 15, and I started again. Boxing was something that I've always done, but then I saw the first Ultimate Fighter, and that was it. Like that
Wow.
was, I had to do that from now on. And then a gym opened across the street from my house. I was 15. I always wanted to train, but there was no gyms around. And then when it opened, I started right away.
Desde sus 15 años empezó Miguel a practicar la pelea. Uh-huh. Y digo, desde pequeñito.
MMA. So, I started fighting everybody.
Tú sabes que todos los niños, I think every child like to fight when they're little.
Yeah, it's something I never grew out of. I never,
My husband used to play karate, and he used to take all the plantains trips. Luis peleaba con las patas de plátano y la cortaba toda.
Cut him down, yeah.
Es muy importante, ahí vamos. 10 fights, 0.
Yeah. So far, God is good. I'm blessed. I'm 10-0. I won amateur 6-0. So, all together, I'm 15 fights on loss.
Señores, un fuerte aplauso. 10-10. Miren ahí. 10-10. Miren a este joven. Miguel, acabando con ese pobre hombre.
They're all tough fighters, so everybody, you know, respect all the fighters.
Dios mío, mira, ahí está Miguel. Practicando. Tell us a little bit about it.
That was actually the fight that got me into the UFC. So, yeah, this is the contender series on ESPN. This was for an opportunity to get into the UFC.
Wow.
I took this fight last second, 12 days notice, and then I got the contract, and I was rewarded.
Amazing,
thank God.
Yeah. Amazing. Wow, incredible. So they gave you the opportunity, and you put it all.
I gave it all. Everything I had to take it.
Wow, amazing, Miguel. Well, let me tell you, I imagine how your mom felt.
Oh, man.
Ay, mama.
Yeah.
I remember when John, because my son is your friend, yeah. Mi hijo es su amigo, y no habló de ti, porque siempre se juntaban donde Manny.
Yeah,
y dice, mami, va a pelear mi amigo.
Shout out to those guys, everybody.
Yes! Mami, va a pelear mi amigo. Oramos por ti, pero también por el otro, para que tú lo dejara vivo.
Thank you, guys. Thank you for that, yeah.
We pray for both.
Thank you.
Sí, porque es difícil.
Yeah,
it's muy difícil. So, I remember the first fight, and then you already had 10 out of 10. That's undefeated.
Yep.
Amazing. Invicto el muchacho. 10-10. Dios te bendiga. Y un fuerte aplauso de nuevo para Miguel.
Gracias. Thank you.
Miguel, do you have any... what do you do before you fight? Do you have any specific training, diet that you have to follow
to
be ready?
A lot of training, yeah. It's so we do a lot of research. Like, so we have. So what happens is the UFC gives us an opponent, and we tend to just say yes, because when you're in the level that I'm at, where I've gotten into the UFC relatively soon, it's kind of important that you take the fights they give you. So I took the fight, and we just do a lot of research on the guy I'm fighting. So they give me the name, I look up his style, I do a lot of research, and I make sure that when I go in there, I know what's going on.
Escuche cómo es esto, señores. Yeah. Ay, ay, ay. This is incredible. Le pregunté a Miguel que si hay mucho entrenamiento y algún tipo de ejercicio que hace antes de sus peleas. Dice Miguel que antes de sus peleas le dejan saber cuál es su oponente, con quién va a pelear. Entonces tiene que empezar a investigar quién es, y empezar a explorar y ver cómo pelea, cuál es su estilo, y estudiarlo, analizarlo, para ver cómo lo va a acabar. Entonces Miguel se prepara físicamente y mentalmente.
Yes, 100%. So I have to be prepared for what he's going to do and be able to solve the problem that's in front of me.
Wow, it's incredible. Believe me, my husband said, "Where would you want to? What would you like to accomplish?"
El cinturón. Yo quiero el cinturón. I want the belt.
Eso, yes, cinturón.
That's the one goal.
You will get it. I'm sure you will get it.
Thank you so much.
Because you have a aim. Tiene un objetivo y estás trabajando para ese objetivo, Miguel. ¿Algún tipo de ¿dónde entrenas? Yo te pregunté, what do you do? Where do you train?
Está entrenando in Miami with my team, MMA Masters.
Okay.
Yeah, they are, I've been with them now 2 years, and they are the ones that got me the opportunity to be in the UFC, so everything's been blessed so far.
Okay.
Like, I've been with them, it's everything working out great, and I have my coach, Cesar Sergei. He's been with me since I was 15, since I first started.
Wow.
Yeah. So it's been... I have boxing coaches. Since it's mixed martial arts, I have to do a lot of different trainings, like boxing, kickboxing, jiu-jitsu, wrestling. So Those guys have been helping me out a lot. My boxing coach, Kevin Gleason, they've all been helping me.
Very good. And now we have a new presenter here, JP, who's going to be with us.
Behind the scenes action right
yes,
now.
Yes, yes, yes. Go ahead, John. You have any question for Miguel?
So I'm from behind the scenes to the scenes.
Hey,
how's it going, everybody?
In front of the camera.
So, you know, there's a couple of things I want to ask you, you know, being like your friend and also seeing you as a fighter. A lot of people think.
Yeah, you can come to me with the. Yeah, you can walk down with me if that's what you want. I got you.
I want to sing while you come
on the way down.
I got you. Now, do you get nervous? And I'm going to ask you this while you're walking towards the cage and while you're in the cage. Like, how do you feel? Like, are you calm? Are you nervous? Or, you know, it's just another fight?
I think, you know, this is, you know, my opinion. My belief is that every fighter is nervous. I don't think anybody goes in there thinking, like, I'm going to go in there and just it's going to be in and out, and I'm going to be, it's over. And if you do that, that's more than likely a bad night for you. So there's a lot of nerves coming up to the fight in the sense of the training camp, the days that you put in, the weeks, the months prior. But when you're there and you're walking to the cage, it's different now. Because now you're, now the belief that the work that you put in is gonna come to, you know what I mean? Like now it's time for the results to show. So it's a kind of a piece almost when you walk into the cage and now it's time. Like you've been thinking about this fight for however long, weeks, months, whatever it is. And when the time comes, it's almost like it's finally here.
Wow.
You've told me that do you kind of like black out once that door closes? Like how, is it kind of like a game, like a zone that you're in, like once, you know, it's time to actually get to work?
It's like it's so hard to explain because, again, like, there's 100 different thoughts. You're thinking, it's like preparing for a test. You know, like, we did the research on the guy, right?
Right.
We drilled and we trained and we made sure that we're ready for this person. So then you're thinking about all these things, like, all right, well, what if he does this? What if he does this? What if he does this? So you have to have the right answers.
Right.
So all of a sudden, when the cage door closes behind you, it's like, time to go. There's no more thinking anymore.
Okay, voy a explicar un poquito de lo que Jan y Miguel están hablando. Jan le preguntaba a Miguel si se ponía nervioso y Miguel le decía que claro que sí, que no, todas las personas que van a ese, perdón.
Está bien.
Okay, ¿está bien ahí?
Sí.
Todas las personas pues se ponen nerviosas y es normal. Por lo tanto, si tú no te pones nervioso, puede ser que sea una mala noche porque tienes que tener mayormente sabe a lo que te vas a enfrentar.
Uh-huh.
También ya me preguntó que si, que una vez le comentó que él entra como, él trata de bloquear todo, que creo que es lo mejor que hace, porque si piensa en los golpes que te van a dar,
yeah,
o lo que tú vas a dar.
When you're in there, you gotta just go. Yeah, you get hit, it's no more thinking, yeah.
Es mejor.
Yeah, like, ow.
I know, definitely. You have to just go and do what you gotta
do. Yeah, you do what you gotta do, exactly.
Kill it. But, don't kill it.
Win, just win. Yeah.
No lo mate, gana.
I think another pretty good question for the time that we're in as far as like 2020 leading to 2021 is you have fought in front of a crowd and you have fought with no crowd.
Yeah.
What are the compare and contrast that you can make to those experiences? Do you prefer one or do you mind it at all? Or like, what's your thoughts on that?
So the biggest difference with the pandemic now and the fighting with and without is the time in between fights and how quickly they have you there in the venue and have you out of it. So before the pandemic, it was you'd be there, you'd get a locker room, you'd kind of sit in there, you'd watch the fights go on, you'd kind of like warm up in the back, and then your time would come and you know do your fight, come back. They'd put all the fighters in a green room where they have like a space for them to like kind of eat and chill. Now it's completely different. Now they have you in and out, because you got to go, and then another group of people are going to come in, and they can't have more than a certain amount of people per room. So you got to leave your stuff in the locker room. The last time when you leave that locker room, is the last time you're going to be there. So take your stuff, put it in the van, and have you go back to your hotel room. But the biggest difference is just there's no crowd, and there's it's tranquilo. It's like, it's okay. Quiet. Yeah, like it's. You hear the punch, you hear the kick, you hear everything, you know.
And you hear the coaches.
Yeah, your coach. It's like they're right here yelling in your
right.
ear. But with the crowd, you know, you can just, it's almost drowned out, you know?
So would you like, let me ask a question. You like the crowd energy or you rather,
After the fight, the crowd's the best. For me, the crowd is after the fight. During the fight,
spoken like a true 10-0.
Yeah.
They should stay quiet.
Yeah.
So that's important because sometimes we can get our...
More information.
Yes. And then if the crowd is, let's say when we come back, maybe the crowd just learned that there are moments that we need to be quiet to give our participants, our fighters, the concentration.
But I don't blame them at all because it's a fight. You know?
You should watch them. Yeah. You should watch Christopher. When you were fighting the back fight, I was in New Jersey. He was like, go,
yeah.
I mean, imagine them there.
And I mean, and then all like, thousands of people.
Imagínate, yo estoy diciéndole que mayormente la gente cuando va a las peleas, pues empieza a decir, dale, oh, este es mi. Entonces dice Miguel que a veces ahora es muy tranquilo y que ayuda a concentrarse y que le gusta el crowd al final de la pelea que celebren. Pero si están ahí, que pues imagínate, era imposible. Porque le contaba que en New Jersey, mi sobrino, que es amigo de él, pues estaba como en el ring. ¡Dale! ¡Eso! Y cuando ganó, ¡uf! Y que se había ganado $1,000,000. No sé si apostó.
I'm going to ask you 2 more questions and we're going to move on to something else.
Okay.
But this is kind of like final thoughts. Do you feel like there's something that you fight for as your career?
When I first started, my goal was to just win. You know, I love fighting, and that's what I enjoy doing. And it was winning the next fight, but then after that, I got a little older, and now that I'm in the UFC and there's more opportunities and, you know, better, I can be better off financially. Now it's for my family, you know, for my friends, for my trainers, for everybody really who supports me, because I know there's a lot of time that they put into me too.
Mm-hmm.
You know, a lot of prayers that they put, you know, they send my way. So it's only and I think I actually had a discussion with you, you know, after one of my last fights that, you know, some of the best parts of coming back from a fight and, you know, again, God willing, I come back with a win is just being able to celebrate with my friends and family. So
amen. We are celebrating with you. Miguel, what advice would you give some of those young adults and even the children about following their goals? ¿Qué consejo le daría a esos jóvenes que te están mirando, a los niños, cuando tienen una meta, un sueño?
I wholeheartedly believe that you should go after what you want. And if you're going to pursue it with the best intention and, like, completely, you can't go after it and think that you're going to make it if you're not going to work hard.
Amen.
That's my whole thing. If you're going to go in there and believe that this will happen for me because, you know, it'll happen. No, mm-hmm. You have to make it happen. You have to, you know, John knows me for how long we've been friends now? Years.
Years, yeah.
And every day I'm at the gym.
Yes.
I tell him, I can't do that. I'm training, you know. It's because I want to reach a goal. I want the belt. I want to be the best. I want to be ready to provide for my brother, my mother, everybody.
Amen.
So then when the time comes and I look back at my career or the goals that I set and I hit them, I want to be like I did everything I could to get there. If I don't, I want to be able to say the same thing, that I did everything I could and that it just didn't happen my way, but I did everything I could.
Amen.
Put the hours and time into it.
Excelente. Bueno, dice Miguel que el consejo que le da a esos jóvenes, a esos niños que están mirando, sería que persigan su sueño, pero que lo persigan de la manera correcta, trabajando para conseguirlo. Porque muchas personas piensan que tienen un sueño y que el sueño se va a hacer realidad sin hacer ningún trabajo. Es decir, Dios te da a ti la oportunidad de que tú logres un objetivo, pero tú tienes que trabajar para lograrlo. Así que Miguel dice que todo el que lo conoce a él siempre está en el gym, siempre está trabajando, entrenando, porque él sabe que es la única manera como él va a estar en forma para poder estar listo físicamente y emocionalmente para su próxima pelea. Y su meta definitivamente vas a ser ese cinturón, que en el nombre de Jesús lo vas a alcanzar. Dame un fuerte aplauso.
Thank you. Gracias.
A Miguel.
I want to do a little quick game with Miguel, if you would be so kind to switch seats with me real quick.
Of course. Sure.
All right, sir.
All right, let's do this.
So I got here a couple of questions. We're going to call it rapid fire.
Okay.
30-second questions. So, you know, we're going to get to know you on a little bit of a different level here.
All right.
Remember, you got 30 seconds, so right. Try not to spend too much time on one. Just whatever comes to your mind, just go for it.
All right.
I'm going to start the timer as soon as I ask you the question. Favorite food?
Pizza.
Wow. Right away. Place you would like to visit?
Japan.
Okay. Favorite movie?
The Water Boy.
Okay. Favorite wrestler?
The Rock, man. You know me. You know that.
Morning or night person?
Night, definitely.
Most important thing to you right now?
My family.
Pet peeve?
You gotta. How much time do you have? hypocrisy.
Okay, we'll leave it at that. All right. You got through most of the questions.
There you go.
There you guys have it, Miguel Baeza.
Take care, guys.
To you live.
Hey.
Thank you for being here, man.
Thank you.
Yes, sir.
Take care, guys.
Bueno, Miguel. Aquí ya estamos llegando al final de nuestro programa. Aquí no están. We're here. We get up. Estamos ya llegando al final de nuestro programa. We feel blessed to have you tonight.
Thank you guys for having me.
Estamos bendecidos de tenerlo. Sabemos que es un joven con mucho trabajo, con mucho entrenamiento, pero también con mucho amor de venir a nuestro programa con buen pie. Y sé que esta no va a ser la última vez. We know this is not going to be the last time.
I'll be back for sure.
Tú vas a volver
much
con el cinturón. Con el cinturón vas a volver. I declare that.
Thank you.
Mira que dicen que yo tengo la boca de profeta. They say they have a prophet. You know, that prophesied.
So I need you on my side. Yeah, I need
you
on my side.
Oh, believe me. So, recuérdate que vas a ganar.
Thank you.
Así que, Luis.